My learned friends, greetings to you from India, the land of Tathagat Gautam Buddha and Mahatma Gandhi, the great messengers of peace. Friends, today I remember the golden words uttered by the great noble son of India, Swami Vivekananda, who in 1896 had said, "In the 21st century, my mother India will be recognized as the knowledge corridor and will show the pathway to peace and happiness to the entire world as Vishwa Guru." Before this, in the year 1893, Swami Vivekananda had also prophesied that the union of science and spirituality or religion alone will bring peace and harmony to the world. Dear friends, I strongly believe that the time has come for all of us to rise above all the chaos, confusion, terrorism and bloodshed, as well as petty considerations like caste, creed, religion, race and gender prevailing in today's world, and adopt a value-based universal education system based on the time-tested Indian culture and philosophy, and work together with dedication, devotion and discipline for the establishment of a peace-loving, holistic global society. Friends, I have a great sense of satisfaction that the MIT World Peace University, Pune, India, has established the biggest dome in the world in the name of great philosopher saints of India, Sri Jnaneshwar and Sri Tukaram, conveying India's message of world peace and humanity. Perhaps for the first time in history, 54 larger-than-life bronze statues of the greatest saints, scientists and philosophers who dedicated their lives for the well-being of humanity and who are the true makers of world history have been installed here under one roof. I earnestly appeal to all of you to realize our noble mission, imbibe this message of peace and humanity, and convey the same to the entire world.